methyl there. 2, 3. Straight 1, 2. Double bond there. Get the yellow in before you get too far ahead of yourself. Double bond over here on that O. Now what we need, there's actually some methyls coming off these nitrogens. So this nitrogen here gets a methyl. This nitrogen here gets a methyl coming off it too. It's just drawing H's, but apparently not. So I gotta go back and look for those. Yeah, those N's got, I've been putting H's. Some got H's, some got methyls coming off. So we'll go back and double check those in a minute. I want to come back and make sure we got all the carbons coming off here. We got two off that, so that's done. We got N double bound O. Got carbon here. I know the side chain's right. 1, 2. The alcohol's going to get 1. Side chain's cool. Coming back around here, these ends, I gotta watch if there's a methyl or an H off it. So this turns out to be a methyl. So when you're looking at the regular structure, there's just a line or an H. The H gets more prominence than the line, and the line means a whole methyl out there. Okay, so this end there, that's got the methyl. End down the bottom. Yeah, these ends got methyls on them. See, I thought they were simple H's, but apparently not. So there's one at the bottom. Go through, fix those. This carbon gets a dot. So that's all you look for now when you're going through there is you got all the hydrogens on there. Let's see, one of these. Was it? There's a couple going in. 1, 2, I got that one. I think next to it. He's got one. Carbon's in. The other side of the end. So I guess this has 1, 2. On screen here, so two carbons in, and two methyls on the side. So we got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, CH2, no big deal. Now we come around looking here. The nitrogen, I've got pointing up. I gotta number these because these are really confusing. So let's start at the top. What I call number 11 is over here. So 11, CH2C, double bound O. This N here gets a methyl. N goes to a carbon with the side chain, which goes to a C double bound O, which goes to an NH, which goes to the carbon with one iso Double bound is in. That nitrogen here gets a methyl on it. Cyclosporin. See, I never knew there was that much to this molecule, but boy, I'm learning, aren't I? Okay, so that nitrogen's got a methyl coming off. This kind of looks like a ring the way it's turning around here. That is an NH. Double bound O. Carbon to this on the inside. That NH goes to a carbon with just a methyl on the side. Double bound O. This is an NH. That's the way it should be. NH goes to a carbon with a methyl on the side to a double bound O to an N with a methyl. Boy, I just thought all those N's were H's, but apparently not. That N goes to a carbon with the one hanging down. Two carbons in. Double bond O up. To an N, a methyl down. To a carbon with a double up. Down, that nitrogen's got the methyl. That nitrogen's got a methyl. So, you got 11 nitrogens. See how big this is? It's too big for the screen here. What are you going to do? Are you going to tell God how to do it? So, it looks pretty bland. Let's go in, color the green first, huh? Green. Green. So you should have a feel for it now. When you have N next to a carbon with a double bonded O, that's the amino acid backbone. So there should be 11 O's in this also, right? 11 double-bounded carbonyls, they'll call it. So what do I see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Hey, we must be doing something right. Over here. So we're not going to draw the aliens on the oxygens because we got enough N's. We got 11 N's in this. Waiting to do some real color in. Here it is. Oh, go in and put our aliens on all the ends, huh? One. Those lone pairs are really important on nitrogen. Gives it. What does that mean? That means the nitrogens are done. Light blue crayons. Let's do the blues here. N. Do these any way you want.